So they have a really delicate balance to walk between keeping us relatively fearful, but not so fearful that we stop what we're doing and really examine how it is that they've been waging.
There are a lot of people who lie and get away with it.
And that we will in fact find weapons or evidence of weapons programs that are conclusive.
I don't think we'll discover anything myself.
It appears that there were not weapons of mass destruction there.
You said you knew where they were.
I did not.
We know where they are. They're in the area around Tikrit and Baghdad and east, west, south, and north.
Well, first of all, I haven't lied.
There are a lot of people who lie and get away with it.
Talking about lies and your allegation that there was bulletproof evidence of ties between Al-Qaeda and Iraq. Was that a lie?
Intelligence gathered by this and other governments leaves no doubt that the Iraqi regime continues to possess and conceal some of the most lethal weapons ever devised.
Are people going to find out the truth? And the truth will say that this intelligence is good intelligence, no doubt in my mind.
I don't know anybody that I can think of who has contended that the Iraqis had nuclear weapons.
And we believe he has, in fact, reconstituted nuclear weapons.
Saddam Hussein is determined to get his hands on a nuclear bomb.
We cannot wait for the final proof.
He's got him. He's got him.
The smoking gun.
He's got him.
That could come in the form of a mushroom cloud.
Colin Powell didn't lie.
My colleagues, every statement I make today is backed up by sources, solid sources. These are not assertions. What we're giving you are facts and conclusions based on solid intelligence.
He has not developed any significant capability with respect to weapons of mass destruction. He is unable to project conventional power against his neighbors.
Are people going to find out the truth?
I have not suggested there's a connection between Iraq and the 9/11.
You have said in the past that it was, quote, pretty well confirmed.
No, I never said that.
Okay.
That's absolutely not. What I said was, it's been pretty well confirmed that he did go to Prague and he did meet with a senior official of the Iraqi intelligence service.
Saddam Hussein aids and protects terrorists, including members of Al-Qaeda. Secretly and without fingerprints, he could provide one of his hidden weapons to terrorists or help them develop their own.
What did Iraq have to do with what?
The attack on the World Trade Center.
Nothing!
He said there were three main reasons for going to war in Iraq. Weapons of mass destruction.
Saddam Hussein has gone to elaborate lengths, spent enormous sums, taken great risks to build and keep weapons of mass destruction.
The claim that Iraq was sponsoring terrorists would have attacked us on 9/11.
Before September the 11th, many in the world believed that Saddam Hussein could be contained.
And that Iraq had purchased nuclear materials from Niger.
The regime is seeking a nuclear bomb.
Now, all three of those turned out to be false.
Just if I might correct a misperception, I don't think we ever said, at least I know I didn't say, that there was a direct connection between September the 11th and Saddam Hussein.
Who does the president think he's effing kidding?
Of course, it was information that was mistaken.
There are a lot of people who lie and get away with it.
Those weapons of mass destruction got to be somewhere. Nope, no weapons over there. Maybe under here.
When you have a precedent set like that, and you have somebody, George Tenet, acknowledging in his book that he knew that the administration was deceiving the American people into a situation that is murdering young men and women from this country and others, that George Tenet and Dick Cheney and Condoleezza Rice and George Bush et al. Should be in fucking jail.
I'm tired of hell, but I'm not going to take this anymore!
Go talk to yourself, Mr. Cheney.
You've got to figure out what to do with
all of the debris.
How about you? You made money off the golf floor! And now you're going to vote for your fascist son!
Old lie! War lie! Still lie! Stop the lie! Stop the war!
Andrew Todd Jr.
It is important step.
Have the power to make this life free and beautiful, to make this life a wonderful adventure. Then in the name of democracy, let us use that power. Let us all unite.